It's over to you, Marcus.
Well, hopefully this won't be the last, but a welcome to Ross Stearn. I'm guessing you're French, because I think when I've looked at it, your middle name is Very, is it? What's your middle name? Ross Very Stearn. Have you got a middle John. Name?
Arthur John.
Arthur John, I couldn't find it. But no? You're 29 years of age, born on the 17th of September, 1990, correct?
Correct.
So you're probably one of the more senior players. Is that right, Cookie? And we'll probably be looking for leadership skills off of Ross this year.
Yeah, I mean, we want him to be vocal in the change room. There's quite a few young ones, actually, that we've brought into the squad, which we've done on purpose. We just thought that the squad needed livening up a little bit with a bit more youth. With youth comes the exuberance and enthusiasm of running around, and sometimes they just need counselling or they need marshalling, you know, to learn the game of football and learn the craft of football as well. So people like Ross and Marlon and Joe Anks, they've definitely got those sort of qualities, yeah. I think.
Along with some of the other squad, I think they mature quite quickly. So looking into you, Ross, obviously I've known you before and worked with you before. Can you give us a bit of you've had more clubs than Jack Nicholas, so you might as well tell us about the clubs that you've had and where you've chased the Yankee dollar, basically. So give us a bit of a rundown so people know your background.
Like you said, I have had a few clubs. Thanks for stating that one, Mac. I'm much appreciated, mate. I obviously come through the youth academy at Bristol City, then come to yourself. I went to Chippenham. When I was like 18, 19, and then I come from Chippenham to Weston, that's where obviously I was with you before, enjoyed my time, and then as you said, we went up the pyramid a little bit, which was good, and signed for I went on to Sutton United for a few years when we won the league and went up to the Conference Prem, and then stayed for a year. And then I went to Eastleigh for a couple of seasons. And then I went back to Sutton United. And then we signed back for Bath. Me and my partner, we had our second child. So me living away in London, it wasn't really the best, nice. The best for my family life. So I come back and signed for Bath, which was a great opportunity for me to come back, and I loved it there. And then that finished in the summer just gone, and now here I am back at Chippenham again. So I've always seemed to come back to the clubs where I've left, which is a good thing, because I've never left on sort of bad terms wherever I've gone. And wherever I've gone back to, I've always been sort of welcomed back to the clubs that I've left, which I think is a good thing.
Yeah, I mean, I've looked at either when it happened. A good friend of all of ours, really, Rob Boyd, messaged me. I'm not on social media, but he sent me a clipping of what some of the Bar fans were saying and regarding on their social media, and it was really good. It was good to show that they actually appreciated what you've done over the last few years for them. So that's got to be a nice feeling for you.
It was massive. I looked it at the time, because when I come out and I sort of left the pro game when I was sort of 18, 19 and had that break from it. Bath was probably the first club where I settled at. When I come back out, I was at Chippenham for a year. Then I went up the league, went to Weston for a year. And then I went up again. We went to Bath, which at the time were probably a bigger club at the time than Weston with what we were doing, and I went there, and it was the first club that I sort of settled at after being like an 18, 19 year old scholar, where I felt comfortable playing, and it felt enjoyable, and I really enjoyed it, and I probably played my best, most maturable spell from being, because I was still young, I was only 22 at the time, 23, for being young, I felt like I'd done well there. And it was nice. I did see a few of the comments. I got obviously tagged in a few, and I read a few. I don't try to look into the social media side of it too much, but because some things can be said and it goes here and there. But no, I did get tagged in a few, and it was nice to see that you were obviously appreciated over the time that I was there, because I felt like I was a good servant for the club whilst I was there, and I felt I contributed a fair bit to the success they had over the years that I was there.
Yeah, and looking at that, Cookie, it's quite refreshing for us to see that a player that you're bringing in is still contributing to the club they used to be at, because sometimes you get players that come out and probably haven't been great, and that's why they've left. So it's good for us, especially bringing in with what the squad we've currently got at the moment.
Yeah, and I phoned up Jerry. I told you to. I had a conversation with Jerry out of courtesy, just to say, we know that Ross has left Bath, and we'll be signing him. And Jerry was very complimentary of him, and he did not have a bad word to say. And that was a nice comment by Jerry, when he said, he's probably done as much for this club over the last few years as anybody, and especially in his time that Jerry's been the manager there as well. So I think, if you can leave clubs on good terms, then that's all the more better for yourself. And if you're a good servant and a good player like he has been, then great. Let's hope he has that coming to us now with Chippenham.
And Ross, obviously some of the fans just know you from when you played before. I got memories of how we utilised you at Western. And I think we finished seventh that year. It was a really good season for us.
Yeah.
What can the fans kind of expect now, where you've got a bit more mature head on your shoulders and adding different parts to your game, or knowing what you can and can't do at this point in your career?
Yeah, like you touched on earlier, I'm coming in now is probably the first time I'm entering a dressing room as probably one of the most experienced players in the dressing room, as that makes sense. And I think that comes with a sort of a little bit of a weight on your shoulders. You're expected to, obviously, the younger ones look up to the older ones in the dressing room. And you're expected to lead as, obviously, like a role model in everything you do, not only playing, but how you carry yourself sort of around the club as well. So it's not only just the playing, they learn a lot as growing up, like I did when I first come to Chippenham. There was players there at the time when I first signed. I was an 18-year-old, just been released by a pro club, and that's going to be the same here. And I hope I can offer some form of help and guidance, as well as playing a big part, obviously, on the pitch. With being there, I'm looking to, obviously, play in one of the forward positions, whether that's on the right, on the left, in behind the striker, or just as comfortable sort of through the middle, and contribute as many goals as I can, and set up as many as we can on the way. And hopefully we can have a good, successful season.
Yeah. And Cookie, we'll touch on it a bit more after the kind of quiz, but it's a great testament to Ross that he's continued and got a decent career out of football since when he left Bristol City. We've had a few young lads that haven't quite got to the scratch of where we currently are as a team, and we've had to let them go. What kind of advice can you give to them that obviously reflecting on what Ross has done?
Well, just before I touch on that, was John Clayton your youth team manager?
He was, yeah.
Yeah, see, people like Marlon, you must have been the same sort of year that
Marlon... Me and Marlon did, we grew up from when we were like 12.
Yeah, and not being funny, if you're getting coached by people like John Clayton, John Clayton's a good coach. Yeah. John Clayton knows his stuff. And if you've been in and around him for a number of years, you're going to come out, whether you go in the pro game or you're not, you're going to come out a good player, and you're going to come out a better player as well. So, the football education that some of these young lads have had at some of the clubs is absolutely fantastic. Some of the clubs, it's not great, if I'm honest. And you have to pick them up by the bootlaces a little bit when they've just got released. And we had this last night with four of the lads who joined on trial. We had 10 trialists altogether. We had five last night playing in the game. And four, over the last couple of weeks in training, have done really, really well. And then they played in the game, not so great, and they're not going to be for us. So unfortunately, it comes down to me to release them. So that's going to be two major setbacks that they've had in their little young career, their fledgling career, where somebody's turned around and said, look, I'm sorry, son, but you're not going to be quite good enough. Now, with us, it's not the fact that they're not good enough. It's the fact that probably they're physically not strong enough and big enough to cope with these demands our level. And so, although it is a no at the moment, it doesn't mean it's going to be a no in 18 months' time. So, you know, we'll be keeping a little eye on him. So, but it's really hard, Ross, isn't it? When you've got to be mentally so tough and resilient. And I'm really full of admiration of people like yourself who do get released by the pro clubs that go on and have an absolutely fantastic non-league career and, you know, get up to some good heights, a good level of football.
It is, people have got to realise it might not be, it's not now, it's not, it just means not never. You've got a feeling that actually some of them might mature, become stronger, learn a little bit more about the game because they're still learning. And like anything, when you're doing a job, you don't just fall into a job and understand it. You've got to take a few years to craft that skill. And I think that's what Ross has done, and hopefully the other guys will as well.
Yeah, definitely.
I think you always get, setbacks in football come the other way round to your working career. Sort of, you get your setbacks sort of straight away in men's football. If you get it early, you sort of, if you're in your working career, you start an apprenticeship and you go on and on and on. And it's not until you get to a standard of at a company or at a position in work that you get dealt a major blow. Whereas in football, it's at 17, 18, just as you left school, it's bam, welcome to the real world. And you don't know anything else. I was sort of,
Or is he going like Norman Collier?
Yeah, he's just going a little bit in and out there though. But just say that again, Ross, because that was good that little bit then.
I said it in football is you get sort of your big blow dealt straight away to you when you're 18, 19. It doesn't come when you're 28, 29. It comes almost straight away. You get told you're good enough or you're not by that club, and that's an opinion. It's then how you deal with that. Do you know what I mean? You can give up then and say, okay, I'm not good enough. I'm not going to play anymore. But you can still go in. You can still go and have a great career in non-league football. At the highest level of non-league football, I only started working the last 2 years. And I know a lot of players that have done that the same. You can go on if you really want to, and you can have a good career out of playing non-league football. It's a standard now where the Conference Premier is 90% full-time clubs. So it's still a hell of a standard to be playing at, and to play it for such a long time now is a testament to the players that are playing in that league, because it is still a hell of a commitment. And if you do still believe in yourself, which the young ones, like you said, that may have left last night should still do, then they could still go, and they've still got a hell of a chance. And it's not the end of the world. Like you said, they might not be physically strong enough or mentally at this time. It's not like they're not going to be that. It's just at this time, they're not quite ready to do that, but they shouldn't never give up.
Yeah, 100%. Have you seen any of these interviews, the previous ones, Ross, at all?
I haven't, no.
Well, the good news is there's always a quiz, and that's Cookie. Me and Cookie have been chatting today. Cookie doesn't know you as well as me. Cookie thinks you're going to do really well.
I categorically am not going to do very well before it even starts.
Because of Derek, it's going to be about... Do you ever... You're 29, so do you ever remember a programme, Going for Gold? Do you remember that?
No.
It was with a guy called Henry Kelly, wasn't it, Cookie?
Yeah.
Right. And he talks about somebody, and you have to guess who that somebody is. And today is based on Going for Gold. Okay. I'm not as good as Henry Kelly by any stretch, because he was a legend. Okay. But I'm gonna give you a little bit how he does it, and then after each one, you can have a guess. If he guesses the first time, Cookie, we give him 3 points.
Yeah.
And then if he gets to the last point of it, we ain't going to give him a point, but you can have a guess. Okay?
So what sort of categories are we talking here?
Famous Ross. They have Ross in their name. Okay? So you should be all right, because in your name, you've got Ross, haven't you?
Yeah, I have, yeah.
So you should be okay. Right. He always started, Henry Kelly goes, who am I? Okay. All right. So I'm going to start with that.
Can you do it? Can you do it with the Irish accent?
All right. Probably not. Good idea.
What was her?
What am I doing?
Do I sound like a dog then? Anyway, first one, Ross. Okay, who am I? I was born in November the 2nd, 1966, sorry, in Flushing, New York. I was born in November the 2nd, 1966, in Flushing, New York. Who am I? Can you get it from that?
Okay.
Second clue. No,
I'm sure there
were
a few people born in 1996.
There's nobody in the world that could get it from that. Give him a few more clues.
That's what this is for. Henry Kelly wouldn't get this abuse. We're going to Clive in Finland. Two, I play the voice of Melvin. Okay.
Melman.
Oh.
Yeah. Don't know who plays him, but.
Okay, listen. It's my fictional name, and I have a group of six friends.
All you got to remember, it's got to be somebody with Ross, isn't it?
I know.
Yeah. I'm Dom, yeah?
The two people that watch this in my family, is it, or maybe three people total watch the whole interviews in the whole of the world, will be shouting now. Okay. My fictional character has a sister called Monica.
Yeah, well, I don't know.
Do you know it, Cookie?
It's Ross off of Friends, isn't it?
Ross Geller. Well done.
Geller.
1-0 Cookie.
No chance.
So
don't watch TV.
If you're not, well, you might be struggling on some of these. Okay. Next one. You're not going to get it from the first clue, but Henry Kelly never gave it away. Okay. Who am I? I was born in Urbino.
I don't know. Someone's signal gone.
Did you hear that?
I think his signal's a little bit tight.
You still on dial up?
Yeah. You're back on now, aren't you, Ross?
Okay.
Yeah, I am, yeah.
Ross, who am I? I was born in Urbino, Italy, in 1979. Okay, clue two. I am known for my speed around the track.
Jockey.
A jockey goes round a race course. Just a clue for you.
The motorbike rider.
Do you want the next clue?
Something Rossi it is, but I don't know the first name.
Okay, the next clue was, I am a multiple MotoGP world champion. Yeah?
Yeah.
And my first name is also a designer brand.
Giuseppe Rossi.
Cookie, tell him.
I don't know.
You're a motorbiker.
Yeah, but I'm not a GP enthusiast. But
is it Giuseppe Rossi or no?
It is definitely Rossi.
Rossi.
Valentino.
That's it.
A different type of trainer, but they're not bad.
Yeah. Well done. Okay. I'm disgusted with you, Michael.
No, thank you for that.
He's a motorbiker. I think that's what they call him. Okay. Number three. Who am I? I was born in November 1960 in St Pancras, London. You can have a guess.
Jonathan Ross.
Come on. Get in there.
I have an OBE. Other clues was I have an OBE and well known for TV and radio. I was a regular pundit on They Think It's All Over. And for me, saying my last name is very difficult. Jonathan Woss. Okay. You've got the... I think you know the rules now.
He's got the hang of the game now, hasn't he?
He's got the hang of it.
Yeah.
It only took him three questions.
The first two questions and just okay.
Number four. That's superb. Who am I? I was born in Glasgow in 1986.
No.
I have played football for Scotland. and started my career at Glasgow Rangers.
No.
Clue three. I've also played for Cardiff, Fulham, Leeds and Villa.
Ross McCormack.
Correct.
Well done. That was super.
It would have been. The last clue was I'm currently on loan at Motherwell.
Good.
Okay.
So Cookie going to be guessing these as well?
No,
he's not supposed to be. But
I'm just the adjudicator, just to make sure there's no cheating, no Googling or anything like that. That's all.
If you can't get it, I go to Malcolm in Finland.
Yeah.
He always used to go to different countries, didn't he? So last one.
So with comparison then to the other two that I've done there, is how am I getting on?
You got to get this one right.
Yeah, you've got to get this one or else you will be known as the thickest bloke in the group.
Has Marlon been yet?
Yeah,
you've got to beat Marlon.
Yeah, he done well, to be fair.
Okay, last one. Who am I? I was born in Detroit, 1944.
Oh, about my age then. Jesus.
No, it looks long. I won't tell you who it is, but they look younger than you. Okay. I am a singer stroke actor.
No.
My genres of music are R&B, pop, soul and disco.
Can you give him male or female to help him out a little bit?
The next one should give it away.
Diana Ross.
There you go.
Well done.
The most famous Ross, that is. Diana the last Ross. One was, I started in a group called the Supremes. You were the guy.
So that was how many did I have then? Two?
That was on the third one you got.
Yeah. He got three then. He got three points. So in total, he's got 9 points.
He only gets a point for the last one.
No,
you can't give him that many. Henry Kelly was not
2 points for the last one.
Yeah, but he's just signed, and I feel a bit sorry for him as well. So let's give him the 3 points. So he's got 9 in total.
Yeah,
so
he's
done well.
Yeah.
All right, we'll let you off.
I started off very bad as well. Very bad.
That is my favourite quiz so far.
Yeah.
I've put a lot of effort into that.
Yeah. Well played. You've obviously got far too much time on your hands, Macca.
It's called time management.
Yeah.
It's
called time management or furloughed.
Yeah.
I'm not furloughed.
I've got neither.
Cookie, we had a game last night. How do you think the lads done?
It's the first game. We mixed in quite a lot of trialists in with the first team. And it's not really about the result. Although the result was good, we won 3-2. But the performance, I thought, was fairly decent for a first game. But there's lots and lots of work for us ahead to work on patterns of play. And what was very pleasing was that we were creating, again, lots and lots of chances.
Yeah.
You know, it's good to watch and it's exciting. And, you know, we had a chat with Jody Bevan, the Fairford manager after, and Reedy, his assistant. And they were very complimentary about us as well and some of our players. And they were great as well because they give us a game. If you're going to go around beating teams, you know, 12, 13, 14 nil, you're not going to get anything out of that. That's going to be rubbish for you. So when it is a bit tight, like it was last night, it's great. That's exactly what we want. It's it's a little cup final for some of them that are trying to impress and maybe trying to get signed on by a bigger and better club as well. So they'll definitely try a little bit harder than normal, but. We were pleased, weren't we, as a coaching staff, because where we are at this moment in time with our fitness, because of what we've done on Strava in the close season, and then going into the third week of pre-season, we're probably about right where we should be at this moment in time. And we've got to time it right, because obviously we would have had, by the time we start the season, nearly a 10-week pre-season, which is obviously a long time. So we don't want to be doing necessarily 3 sessions a week in August, but we do want to be doing that in September. And obviously, we just ratchet it up a little bit as we get, you know, closer to that month, September, and getting into October. So all's good at the moment. Yeah, very good, very pleased.
Obviously, you played as well, Ross. How did you find it? Obviously, he wasn't in with the first couple of sessions with us, but I know you had just come off of your promotional attempt promotional campaign with Bath. How did you find it yesterday?
Hot. But no, it was good. It was nice to be like back in and around the group again. I enjoyed training last week when I come in for the couple of sessions, and yeah, it was good. It was, like Cookie said, it was a little bit frantic at the start. You had a lot of trialists sort of mixed in, and they're all trying to impress, and the team we're playing against are playing against a team in 3 or 4, 5 levels above. So they're obviously going to run around a lot more and try even harder, as you said. But once the game settled down, I thought we played some decent stuff, and the pitch wasn't brilliant because of obviously the weather we've had, and it was bone dry, and it was tough to sort of try and play the football we wanted to play. But I felt we'd done it in areas well, and yeah, like I said, there's a lot to work on. But seeing as that was though the first game that we'd all had together, and there was a fair few trialists mixed in with that, I thought we'd come out of it with a lot of positives. Obviously, there's a lot to work on, like finishing wise and stuff like that. We probably could have or should have won by 6 or 7 come the end, but it was a good exercise, and I think everyone got what they should have out of the game.
I think one thing for pre-season, and Cookie back me up on this, is you use it to get fit for the start of the season. It's not there to worry over results, okay? If the performances are there, we're happy, okay, because you're doing the right things. It's about getting players ready for this year, for the 3rd of October. And coming out of a game where you've seen the first couple of goals, especially the second one, I believe, was very much what we're about. We switched a really good bit of play, got the ball forward into the channel for Alex Bray, and he created a chance. And then, pleasing for the third one, you were involved in it. There was a lovely little bit of passage of passing, then just nicked down the side for Luke Ross, where Luke Ross crossed it in, and kind of Brad Ash with a Gary Lineker kind of finish across at the near post. So, some real positives, but like you said, a lot to work on, because we've got to make sure that we're gearing up to the friendlies at the end when you're looking at your Torquays and Hereford. Is that right, Michael?
Yes, it is, Marcus. And I think, you know, if we haven't got a performance and we haven't got the result, then we're going to come down heavy on the lads. And, you know, and sometimes you've got to look at yourself as a coaching department, because are we doing the right things then? But if you get in pre-season, if you get one or the other, then it's not too bad then to start off with. It is all about timing and getting them right. Again, we didn't pick up any injuries. And there was one or two of the first team players who didn't play as well. And they'll be playing against Buckland on Saturday. There's a couple that have got a drop out for the Buckland game, so they'll come in, so that'll be nice. So it gives a few more minutes, but we certainly don't really want to be giving 90 minutes too soon to too many at this moment in time. What was also pleasing, which I think should warrant a mention, was the young academy goalkeeper came in, Ben Hughes, and he's only just moved up here this week from Swansea. And I've got to say, I thought he'd done tremendous for a 16-year-old lad coming in.
Yeah.
Will's got a bit of a calf strain, so he's rested at the moment. And he looked really good, didn't he, Mac? I don't know what you...
Yeah. I think what we noticed from him and modern-day goalkeeper, his distribution was good. Again, physicality in that side of the game, he's going to come. But he looked quite accomplished. He came out, he was sweeper keeper. I thought he'd done really well. And I think one thing which is pleasing for me and you, Cookie, is that people like Ross were like the first ones to go, actually, well done, and go to congratulate him and pat him on the back, which would mean more than at times us.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely.
No, I thought he was brilliant.
Yeah.
I thought he was really good.
What we couldn't hear about his talking on the pitch. Did you get much of a gauge from his talking and stuff like that, Ross?
Yeah, I thought he was good. He sort of the only thing, unfortunately for him, that he had to do as in talking wise was obviously the free kick that they had on the edge of the box, and the lads smashed it in the top corner, which was a great free kick. But he was confident. He was assertive, like setting the wall out. He sort of come out. He knew exactly what he wanted to do and how he wanted to do it, and generally in the game he was talking as well, which he hasn't really been in training with us. He come in on Thursday last week and sort of was in and around it for an hour or so. Didn't know anyone's names, didn't know anyone, but he come in. I thought he was excellent. Like you said, his distribution was really good. He come out, he was pinging it left and right, and apart from that, he didn't make a mistake. His handling was good. He was really good, and yeah, I think he will go on to be a very good keeper.
And I think it's pleasing to see how the lads from last year have carried on with their performances. Like Bray looked dangerous, and others, Cookie. But I was pleased to also see Joe Hanks fit in nicely, Spence, and some of the new faces as well that we had.
Yeah, and it was for us to try different systems of play and see what benefits us as a team. I thought, you know, we played a 3-5-2 last night, and you know, we were particularly looking at Ryan Case on the right hand side and Spence in the middle and KP on the left hand side. And you know, I thought they coped with it well when they had the ball and when we didn't have the ball as well. There was times when Fairford were playing two up front, so you know, there was only one spare man, and then there was times they played three up front, you know, we're getting a few more forward. So that was good for them to see and play, because you know, there might be a situation when we might start the season like it, you know, in the first four or five games, or we might not play that system until after Christmas and you know, we're sort of losing a game or whatever and we want to change things. So it's just handy to practice these things. And I think while we've got quite a long lay into, you know, the first game of the season, then this is a good opportunity for us to do these things. And sometimes they're going to work and sometimes they're not. And that's just the way it is.
Yeah. That's all the questions I got. I thought you performed bang average, Ross, in the quiz. But look, welcome to the club. You've been here before. I come on loan at Chippenham and obviously played there for a month, so the fans will know what to expect. So, but well done, Michael.
Cheers, Ross. Thank you very much.
Cheers, Ross.
Cheers.